Is this the five things? The five things?
Okay, yeah, let's do the five things that attracted us to each other.
Eyes, lips, nose, hair, teeth.
Gross. Okay, I'm gonna get...
Okay, one is how beautiful you are.
Oh, thanks, babe.
That's why I said all those physical things.
You love Jesus. It's my first one.
Oh, can that be my first? Two. Which sounds weird.
You're funny.
Go ahead.
I like that you're funny because I like to laugh.
Oh, good.
You have fuzz on your face.
Get it.
Oh, that's skin. Cool. It's gross.
What are we at? Number three. You're super passionate. About what? Everything.
It is true. I'm pretty passionate about most things. He's funny. He loves Jesus.
What? That's it? That's all you need?
No, you're super hot.
Oh.
Oh.
Can we go in the depth on that? No.
You got a great body. You got a great build. You have a great smile. Everything's proportionate. You look great.
Great. I had my fourth and then it left me.
I don't think you're on four. I think you're on two, right?
No.
Oh, passionate was number three.
Beautiful, beyond description. That's love Jesus.
Oh, okay, thanks.
Passionate. Super smart.
Oh.
Super.
Really? Even smart? Jason's also very, very smart.
But I feel like I'm a little smarter.
You might be. You probably
are. I doubt it. We are smart and different. Capacities.
Thank God. Yeah,
which makes us superhuman smart together.
we both have common sense. Do I have a booger in my nose?
No.
I just like gasped as if I do.
A gasp.
That's my worst fear, you guys. Okay, so when I was on Days of Our Lives, I literally used to, you know, those like elevator doors open and people walk off. Well, obviously we were fake elevators, and I would literally just walk up to the background artist, which are the people that walk around in the background, and that is a job, and they're awesome, because it's kind of, like, not, it's like a good job, unless you want to act, and then it's really kind of disparaging. But I would literally walk up to them and be like, do I have anything in my nose? And they're like, what? I was like, do I have anything in my nose? And they're like, no, that's my worst fear, because soap operas, like, super zoom in on your face, and like, what if you have a bat in the cave? So anyway, so Jason looked at me, and he gave me, like, this look, and I was like, what, do I have something in my nose? So...
No, you don't.
What?
I don't think. No.
Okay, good.
Did you?
Have we done? Wait, no, smart. No, I haven't. No, and I was just going to say that we both.
You just copied mine.
No, I was going to say we both have common sense, which is really good. Except, no, okay, so also, like, what attracts me, one of my favorite things about you, maybe, is that you are also, we're very different.
Super.
Yeah, like we're the same on like our top four. Like we like kids, we agree with discipline, which is a subpoint of number one. We agree on politics, we agree on religion, and we agree on money. I also love that Jason's a drummer.
Oh, yeah.
I really love music, and that's one of the ways we met. And
I
so
forgot I play drums.
Because Jason's actually really creative. He just doesn't know it.
No, I know
that's
that.
Why you need me.
I know it. I just
you do know you're creative.
Don't like to flaunt it.
You're so creative.
My mama said I was special.
Did she?
No. Well, she probably did.
Sorry, Donna.
I never call her mama. That's weird.
That's weird. I never call my mama either, but my boys call me mama and I love it.
What are we on? Five?
I don't know. Look, you love Jesus, you're hot, you're funny, we're different, and yeah, and you're a drummer.
You're different. and you're super hardworking. Did I already use super?
Probably.
As an adjective.
Jason uses the word super because I say the word super, and that's what happens when you're a couple.
You're very hardworking.
Extremely.
Yep. She might not be the best at something, but she will outwork the best and be the best.
Thanks, babe. That is true. That's why I succeed in life, because I 100%. Had to try 110% to get, like, maybe
it's
a B.
It's not possible.
What?
You can only get 100%.
But that's why I like Jason, because I'm a storyteller and I can be prone to exaggeration. And Jason constantly brings me back to
I know you,
the truth.
In baseball, you can bat 1,000, which is also not true. 100%.
I don't like baseball. Sorry, guys. It's my last sport of choice.
In numbers, you can go over 100%. Like talking on returns on investment and stuff.
Okay. Jason has a finance degree.
But giving over 100%, it's just not possible. And I would love for someone to prove that wrong.
Yes, please comment below if you figured out.
Because I will reprove your response wrong.
Time space continuum. The whole norm. I know I really feel like I have something in my nose, do I?
All right, I think we got it. Let's go check.
Okay, so.
So now what?
I really don't have anything
in my nose. Oh, there is something. Like, left nostril, midway.
I know, I can tell, I can feel it. I'll be right back.
Part two. Take two.
Part two, subcategory. Yeah, take two. That's better. Okay. I wonder if I look really tall right now.
I'm slouching a little back.
Good. So this is the type where I'm a giant. What were we talking about? What we were attracted to each other. Clearly my English.
Did you get it out? Okay.
I got the thing out of my nose. Jason tells everything as it is. And I am blunt. That's true. Like, kind of to a fault sometimes, I hate it about myself.
A little bit offensive sometimes.
Yeah, because I'll just tell you, like, if you want to know before you get married if you should marry the guy, like, I'm the friend that'll be like, don't, he's a total jerk. Maybe I'll use more colorful words. And then if you get married, I will tell you before you got married that you shouldn't have married the guy, but then once you get married, I will cheerlead you, and I will say that. Mm-hmm. Because I don't think that you should.
She's a great friend.
Oh, thanks,
I'm up to, like, 10 attractive qualities.
You're a great dad, which I'm is decent. Not why I married him, because he did not have kids before me.
No.
Which is probably one of the things that attracted me about Jason, too, is that you're, like, very pure. Actually, on our wedding day, my older brother, I only have one older brother. No. What? He was like, okay. On my wedding day, Michael, who was friends with Jason, it's like one of the ways, maybe, let's say one of the gazillion ways that we got together. Michael said to me, on my wedding day, guys,
I think I know this one.
He was like, hey, if your marriage fails, I'll know it's your fault.
Do his voice.
He's like, hey. He's like, hey.
It's not his voice, but it's funny.
Hey. He's like, hang on, I just like drinks. Jennifer. He's like, if you guys end up getting divorced, totally full. And I was like, what? Like, I was like, thanks for the marriage prep talk. And he was just like, let's be honest. Jason wouldn't even cheat on Frito-Lay. Yeah. And it's true, because Jason works for Frito-Lay.
I only buy Frito-Lay products.
And even when we were so poor, we should talk about our first year of marriage.
That's maybe a next...
Yeah, it's maybe like a next session. Thing. Okay, next sessions. Next sessions.
Week. Next tomorrow.
So Michael was like, if your marriage ends, it's going to be your fault. And I was like, boom, 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 slap her across my face. Like, you jerk. Like, why would you say that to me on my wedding day? And I did probably say that and probably like started crying and then was like, don't ruin my makeup. And he was like, because Jason won't even cheat on Frito-Lay. And like, not as if I cheat on people, but I would say that out of the two of us, if somebody was going to be... Infidel? What is an infidel?
Infideled. Yeah, an infidel.
Yeah, correct. It would be me, which, like, I won't, so, like, don't come asking, because he put a ring on it. But I'm just saying, actually, like, no, neither of us would cheat on each other. But that is something that if you're, like, not married yet, or you're in a relationship, you should make sure that, like, you still have your guard up. Because when your guard is down, and you think, like, oh, I would never, then, like, maybe.
Oh, you mean
maybe,
personally.
Like, yeah, I'm just...
Like, not have my guard up, like, oh, is she going to cheat on me?
Yeah, no, right. I'm just saying, like personally, like, when I am an actress and I go to set, then I need to be like, hey, just so you know, like, I like my husband, and...
another attractive quality.
Thanks.
Yeah.
But Jason's super loyal. We were so poor, and that's, like, another thing, and he would not cheat on Frito-Lay, even.
Fine name brand. And they have some cheaper options.
Also, you know what's annoying is that you've never had a headache. I get headaches all the time. Like, I feel like I have one right now, which is what prompted me to say that.
Probably just need more coffee.
But Jason and I balance each other, which is also a really good thing when you have a relationship. You know, if anybody wants to psychoanalyze us right now, by the way, I think that my body language is I don't like you because my arms are crossed and my legs are crossed away from you.
Let
me fix that.
This really is...
comfortable? I think it's pretty comfortable.
It's okay.
Maybe if your arms aren't so big.
They're not.
Jason has really long arms.
I do have long arms.
I have really big hands for my body.
You once said I was proportional.
You have a great build. You have a great smile. Everything's proportionate. You look great.
I do have long arms.
You do have long arms. I have really big hands. But they're not man hands. They are granny hands.
Yep. They, no.
The Guys, palms. My hands are so dry. Is it the palms? I don't even know if we can zoom in. It's like, I have the driest old lady hands. And here's why. Okay, let's talk about that. When I was a kid, I was obsessed with Laura Ingalls Wilder. You know this?
I know that, but I don't know where this has gone.
You don't? You haven't heard me say this story like a thousand times? Okay, so I was obsessed with Laura Ingalls Wilder. Is she still alive? I hope so. If you are, Laura, I love you. And they were like, Pa, or somebody in the story was like, hey, you can always tell a lazy person because they have nice hands. And I was like, ain't nobody calling me lazy. So I got outside and I would like rough up my hands, like for real, as a 9-year-old. I remember I got grounded because I used my dad's axe, which was like,
I remember that.
Horrifying, as a parent. Like, oh my gosh, I got grounded for like 6 months from the radio, I remember, radio, TV, phone, and like, we're not talking cell phones, kiddos, I'm talking landline, I couldn't call any friends. The radio, TV, the phone.
No internet to cheat.
No friends, there was no internet.
Well, there was, but only for military.
Because I'm so old right now, but if you looked at my hands, you'd be like, oh, it's an 80-year-old woman, and my friend Steve Robillard from college used to tell me that he liked to hold my hands because it was comforting. Like he was holding Nana's hands. But I don't have lazy hands, okay?
Yeah.
Like you'd look at my hands and you'd be like, oh, she's so wise.
She's feel weird. She's so old. You could be a hand model.
I could not be
for the older model. Generation. Hand cream.
Are you a baby boomer?
You could be doing like the medicine. You could be the one handing. It would be great. I don't know, like arthritis like medicine.
You zoom in and smile instead of manas?
Yeah. Because you know how to act. I don't know.
This looks like, sounds like a Seinfeld episode. That could be draped in velvet.
If it was socially acceptable.
Yeah.
Anyway.
These pretzels are making me thirsty.
It's not even that funny.
It's the best episode.
You think so?
For sure.
That can be funny, I think.